In our previous lecture, we have learned about Gauss law in dielectrics. So that is integration over closed surface KEdS is equals to Q by epsilon naught. Now today in our class, let us try to learn electric displacement. So this electric displacement is basically denoted by D. So what is this electric displacement? So to understand this, so consider a charged spherical conductor. So this is a charged spherical conductor. So the radius of this charged spherical conductor be R, so which is enclosed by charge Q. So now electric field at any point on the surface will be given by what? E is equals to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into R square. Why? Because E is equals to force by Q. So from Coulomb's law, what is force? Force is equals to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R square. So this is force. So if you divide Q to the force, you will get electric field. E is equals to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into R square. So here R is radius of the charged spherical conductor. So now if you take this epsilon to the left hand side, what will happen? So epsilon naught multiplied by E will be given by Q divided by 4 pi R square. Right, so what we have done? So we have just taken epsilon to the left hand side of the equation. So now you have a constant 4 pi R square. So 4 pi R square will give you area of the conductor or surface area of the conductor. A is equals to surface area of conductor. So let us replace this whole term with A. So what we'll get? Epsilon naught E is equals to Q divided by A. So we got an equation. Now I'll write epsilon naught E is equals to D. So this is electric displacement. So replace this term with D. What will happen? D is equals to Q divided by A. So D here is called electric displacement, and it is defined as the product of electric field and the permittivity of free space. So epsilon naught is the permittivity of free space. D is called electric displacement. So now what is the definition for electric displacement? Electric displacement can be defined as the product of electric field and the permittivity of free space. So that is डी. सो डी इज एप्सिलॉन नॉट ई. सो डी इज व्हाट? डी इज इलेक्ट्रिक डिस्प्लेसमेंट. एंड द फॉर्मूला फॉर और एक्सप्रेशन फॉर डी इज एप्सिलॉन नॉट मल्टीप्लाइड बाय डी. सो नाउ वी हैव अंडरस्टूड व्हाट इज इलेक्ट्रिक डिस्प्लेसमेंट. सो नेक्स्ट लेट अस ट्राई टू गेट रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन इलेक्ट्रिक डिस्प्लेसमेंट, इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एंड पोलराइजेशन. सो इन आवर लास्ट क्लास वी हैव लर्न व्हाट इज इलेक्ट्रिक. We have not learnt about electric field, but we have learnt about polarization. So with that, let us define the relationship between D, E and P. So next, we have relation between electric displacement D, electric field E and polarization P. So, in our last class, we have understood what is polarization. So, now let us consider a dielectric slab which is placed between the plates of charged parallel plate capacitor. So, you have two charged parallel plate capacitor, and in between this, what we have done is we have kept the dielectric. So, this is dielectric. And these are charged parallel plate capacitor. Now, so due to polarization of this dielectric materials, charges are induced at the surface of dielectric. So what will happen? So when this dielectric is kept in between the plates, so there will be electric field in this direction. So because of this electric field, so the negative charge which are there in this dielectric will come to one side of the dielectric slab, and the positive will go to other side of the dielectric. Why? Because electric field will generate from the positive charge and will end up in negative charge. So since field line is like this, so here we can assume that plus charges are there. So if there is a plus charge here, so the charges in the dielectric, that two negative charges will get attracted to this positive charges. Next, so the electric field ends at negative charge. So there is a negative charge here, and here we get the positive charge layer. So due to this, there will be induced charges at two different surfaces of the dielectric, and because of this charge, there will be induced electric field, and that will be in this direction, right? So this electric field is induced electric field because of this charges, two charges. And these charges are induced at the surface of dielectric field. So what happened here? Negative charges are induced on the one side of the dielectric near the positive plate, and the positive charges are induced on the other side of the dielectric near the negative plate. So now if Q is the charge on the plates, so here Q is charge on the plates, and Q prime is the induced charge on the boundaries of the dielectric. So induced charges on the boundaries of the dielectric. So So for this, we have found the resultant electric field between the parallel plates of a capacitor in presence of this dielectric. So the equation was, so E is equals to Q minus Q prime divided by epsilon naught A. So previously we have done equation for electric displacement. For electric displacement, what we need is epsilon naught multiplied by E. So let us take this epsilon naught to the left hand side. So epsilon naught E is equals to Q minus Q prime divided by A. So now let us separate these two terms. Epsilon naught E is equals to Q by A minus Q prime by A. And now, so Q prime is what? Induced charges. Q is what? Original charges. So let us write Q by A, the charges which were present before this dielectric induces charge, that is Q by A. So Q by A will give you what? Surface charge density. So Q by A is equals to epsilon naught A plus Q prime by A. So clear? So now let us write this term Q prime by A as P. What is P? So induced charge per unit area of dielectric be the polarization. So A here is what? A here is area. So this can be written as P. Q by A is equals to epsilon naught E plus P. So Q by A is equals to epsilon naught E plus P. So D is equals to epsilon naught E plus P. So what is D here? D is equals to Q by A. Charge per unit area. So here we have D, E, P. So this is the relation. So here you can see. So D is equals to epsilon naught E plus P. So D is equals to Q by A. So this D is equals to Q by A we learned in electric displacement expression. So wherein we got D is equals to Q by A. So that we called as electric displacement, and it is defined as the product of electric field and the permittivity of free space, that is epsilon naught E is equals to Q by A. So with that we are writing D is equals to epsilon naught E plus P. So here D means electric displacement. So this is a vector quantity. E is electric field. So this is again a vector quantity. And P is polarization, and this is again a vector quantity. So this equation has D, E, P vector. So here we got the relationship between the electric displacement D, electric field E, and the polarization P. So in with related to this equation, we have few points to know. So let us know them. Notes. So this D is connected with free charge only. The lines of D begin and end on free charges. D is constant throughout the capacitor. So we know that D is connected with free charges only. So it is not connected with induced charges. So the first here is D is connected with the free charge only. The lines of D begin and end on free charges. So D is constant throughout the capacitor. So you should understand this. D is constant throughout the capacitor and D is connected with the pre-charge only. Now next let us understand what does P mean. So P is what? P is polarization. So P is connected to, so second point, P is connected with polarization charge only. So the lines of P begin and end on polarization charges. Next, electric field E. E is connected with all charges. E is connected with all charges. Clear? Next, fourth. In isotropic medium, or media, P and E are in the same direction. But in non-isotropic medium, P and E are in different direction. So last point here is E is reduced side, reduced in side dielectric. So these are the 5 points that you have to understand with the equation D is equals to epsilon naught E plus P. So this is the relationship between D E P, and with this relation we have to understand these 5 points. Next, let us move to the electric susceptibility. So what is electric susceptibility? So let us see. So if you have a dielectric material and if you place this in an electric field, then what will happen? This becomes electrically polarized. So this we learnt in our previous lecture. So if you have when a dielectric material is placed in an electric field, it becomes electrically polarized. Okay, so for isotropic dielectrics, polarization vector P will be directly proportional to what? Electric field. So P is directly proportional to, next P, so remove this proportionality constant, what we will get is epsilon naught into psi E. So epsilon naught into psi is called P by E, or here it is defined as the ratio of electric polarization to the electric field strength. Electric susceptibility is defined as the ratio of polarization to the electric field strength. So this is what electric susceptibility is. So it is the ratio of electric polarization to the electric field strength, that is P by E. So this is electric susceptibility. Next, let us try to understand atomic polarizability. Atomic polarizability. So what is atomic polarizability means? So before going to atomic polarizability, so let us know what is atom. So what is atom? So atom is a smallest unit which consists positively charged nucleus and negatively charged electrons around it. So if you have an atom like this, so let us call this as nucleus. So nucleus will be positively charged, so which has got protons and neutrons within it. So around this nucleus there will be electrons which are rotating. So these are electrons. So let's suppose, so there are electrons which are rotating around the nucleus. So this as a whole is called atom. So atom is electrically neutral. Why? Because it has the same number of positive charges and negative charges. Because of that, atom as a whole is electrically neutral. So when this neutral atom, so this atom, if we go and place this in an electric field, then what will happen? So we basically have negative and positive charges in the atom. So now if you keep this in the electric field, so there will be creation of two different regions. So one region will contains only positive charge and another region will contains only negative charge. So this will be influenced by the field. So this separation of two charges will be influenced by the electric field. So because of electric field, so the positive charges or the nucleus is pushed into the direction of field and electrons in the opposite direction of the field. So if you have electric field like this, so this nucleus will be pushed in the direction of electric field because this is positively charged, and electric field will come from positive charge and end at negative charge. So this positively charged nucleus will pushed in the direction of electric field, and the negatively charged electrons will be pushed in the opposite direction. So this creates the separation between the two oppositely charged particles, and their center of gravity will also tend to be separated along the direction of the field. So this tendency will be opposed by the electrostatic attraction between two kinds of charges, between the two kinds of charges, until a state of equilibrium will be reached. So now here atom, after the application of electric field, will get polarized. So polarization means, so here after the application of electric field, the positively charged nucleus and the negatively charged electrons will get separated. Because of that, the center of gravity of positive charge and the center of gravity of negative charge will also get separated by few finite distance. So because of this, atom will get polarized. So with plus charge, shifted slightly one way, the minus charge will get slightly shifted to the other way. So atom now behave like a tiny dipole. So positive charge in one side and negative charge on the other side, separated by a distance. So this atom will now behave like a dipole, and this atom will have a dipole moment P, which points in the direction of electric field. So P here is dipole moment. So this induced dipole moment will be proportional to electric field. So P is dipole moment, and this induced dipole moment is proportional to electric field. So if you remove the proportionality constant, then you can write P is equals to alpha E. So here it is proportional constant, not proportionality constant, it is a proportional. So here this is alpha. So alpha P, so if you remove the proportionality, then you get proportional constant, proportionality constant alpha. So P is equals to alpha E. So this constant of proportionality alpha is called atomic polarizability. Atomic polarizability. So alpha is atomic polarizability. How did we get that? So we understood an atom to get polarized, we need the electric field. So if there's electric field, then atom gets polarized. So P is directly proportional to E. So with that, if you remove the proportional between dipole moment and electric field, then you get alpha. Alpha is known as atomic polarizability. So this is all about the atomic polarizability, and we also learned the relationship between electric displacement D, electric field E, and polarization P. So the equation for this is D is equals to epsilon naught E plus P, and after this we learned electric susceptibility. So it is defined as the ratio of a polarization to the electric field strength. So that can also be written as P by E. So that is electric susceptibility. So in the next class, let us try to understand relationship between dielectric constant and electric susceptibility. So what is this electric susceptibility? It is P by E. So next class we'll understand the next derivation, that is relation between dielectric constant and electric susceptibility. So this is for this class.